Hello guys, and welcome to this little explanatory video. Now, a lot of comments, well, not exactly a lot, but some comments in my Let's Play have, well, expressed some kind of disbelief or lack of understanding of why the Decocaine attack works. Now, first, it's not Decocaine. You are not getting anyone off drugs, okay? It's Dick for Richard O'Kane, which was a famous commander of World War II, commander of USS Tang. Before that, executive officer on USS Wahoo, and the orders of Dudley Morton, one of the most successful attack submarine captains of World War II. Decocaine himself was a really successful captain on USS Tang. And yeah, this way of attacking is actually named on his honor. So, I'm not going to explain the trigonometry laws behind this. I mean, I'm sure none of you wants to listen to a long math lesson, right? Do you? Some of you might, but most of you don't. So, let's put this in practical terms so you can understand why range doesn't matter in a decocaine attack. Now, let's say this is an intersection, a road intersection, two perpendicular streets which are crossing in here. Now, let's say that I am roughly here. Let's put a marker down here. Come on, marker. Okay, I am here in my car and I'm moving normally towards the intersection, but suddenly, oh surprise, I spot another car, which is, let me check on this, I'm heading directly towards the intersection, right? Let's picture it there. So I'm moving this way. But, oh surprise, suddenly I'm going to stop the simulation because it's working and I don't want it to work. Suddenly, I'm here. There's a little error, but I'm not going to worry about it. For picturing purposes, I spot someone 45 degrees off my right, right? So in this direction. He's moving towards the intersection as well. So he is, this is going to be a problem. Let me put it here instead. So he's moving 45 degrees. Right? So we have myself, who am, well, let's say 2,000 yards away, and we have him who is 1,900 yards as well. I mean, we are both at the same distance of the intersection. I'm traveling at 10 knots, he's traveling at 10 knots. If we keep this up, we are going to collide, right? I mean, it's pretty obvious to see. However, what will happen if instead I am, let's extend this down to 4,000 yards. Let's extend it to 4,000 yards. So, excuse me, if I'm down here, this guy will appear at a 45 degree angle for me. So if I keep this speed up and he keep his up, we are going to collide anyway. Right? I mean, it's pretty obvious to see. If we are even farther down here and the bearing is the same, 45, he's going to be at the same distance from the collision point. We are going to collide. It doesn't matter whether he's 8,000 yards, 7,000 yards, whatever. Okay? We are going to collide. So the idea is that as long as you have a bearing and a speed and an AOB in a perpendicular course to your target, range doesn't matter. Distance doesn't matter. If you set something to collide, you are going to collide. Right? Now let me explain a little bit the TDC of the American submarines, or any submarines for that matter. Okay, let's bring this up. And let's artificially mount one of my scenarios. So let's say that the enemy is coming from my right. Let's up this a bit. Let's say that the enemy is coming from here and is going to cross my bows from right to left. Now, what I always do is to take maybe 20 degrees here of my bow towards the direction the enemy is coming from. 20 degrees towards right if he's coming from the right, 20 degrees of the left when he's coming from the left. So in this scenario, 20 degrees of the right. Now, what the torpedo radar computer does is if I tell him, well, torpedo radar computer, I have a target which is coming from this bearing at this speed, and its relative angle on bow towards me is this, and I can see it in this bearing. Where do I need to launch the torpedoes towards to hit him? Okay, let's put an instance. For instance, let's say that I'm currently seeing an enemy which is coming like this. I'm 50 degrees of his bow on the port side. I send that to the data computer. And as you can see, here it is. The same data I provided to him. Then I tell the torpedo data computer, hey, this dude is moving at 6 knots. Torpedo data computer says, okay, he's moving at 6 knots. And now I tell him he's at whatever range, let's say 5,000 yards. And at this bearing. With this, I'm sending both the bearing and the range to the data computer. So I'm telling him, look, I'm seeing a guy 5,000 yards away from me, which is coming with an AOB of 50 at a speed of 6 knots, and I see it in the bearing of 20 degrees. Then the torpedo data computer goes and tells me, okay, for this guy, you need to drop a torpedo, see, bow torpedo gyro angle 11. It says, okay, you will need to fire a torpedo in bearing 11 in order to intercept that target. Right? Okay. The thing is that, remember the scenario of the crossroads we saw just before. Let's put back on what I usually do. The enemy is crossing perpendicular to me. So when he's directly ahead of me, here, he will be 90 degrees of the bow from me. Like so. He will be like that, perpendicular to me, because we are in perpendicular courses. Now, if instead of being in front of me, he's in this course, he's not here yet, but I aim here, when he's here, he will be 90 degrees minus 20. He will be at 70 degrees of angle on bow. If I see him at 50, he will be at 90 minus 50. He will be at 40. I mean, it's direct. As you move the scope, as the bearing changes, his AOB changes, but we have a reference point. Here is going to be 90, no matter what, if we are in perpendicular courses. So the AOB is very easy to calculate that way. So I say, okay, torpedo data computer, I'm going to have an enemy which is at 20 degrees of my starboard bow with an AOB of 70 and a speed of whatever, 6 knots. Okay? And the torpedo data computer tells me you need to fire a gyro angle of 9. Right? The thing is that as long as you are in perpendicular courses, the principle we saw before applies. If you are traveling, if instead of being 100, let's go back. If instead of being at 2,000 yards, you are at 4,000 yards. The dude is here, the dude who's there is instead of at, well, whatever, is here. Okay, if we are here and we are here, but we are traveling at twice the speed, we are going to collide anyway, right? Right. If you see that here, this is at 25 degree bearing, right? Now let's see what happens if we double the distances involved. I mean, this is to see, to make you see that what matters is the bearing, not the range. This is, let's say, 6,000 yards, and he's, come on, don't do this to me now. There, he's at 3,000 yards. What do you think is going to happen with this angle? Bring it down here. Surprise! It's the same angle. Well, it's one more because this is not exactly precise. You have seen me. If I did this to the millimeter, this would be 25 also. And if we are at twice this range, and this at twice this range, but we are at moving faster than him twice in an interception course, the bearing won't change. The bearing is going to be 26 if we are here and he's here, etc., etc., etc. Right? So what we are doing here is causing a collision. I'm feeding data into the data computer. And it's telling me, in order to collide, you need, with the speed settings you are using in your torpedo, because if you see this, if I put this, bueno, sadly it's still loading, damn it. Oh no, we are loading all the, damn it. Well, whatever. Let me wait a bit and you'll see. Okay, now we have all the torpedoes loaded. These ones are steam. I can select a fast speed sec. You will see that now, if I give the same orders, it's telling me it's going to fire at a more steep angle. Before it was 9, now it's 13, because the torpedo is traveling faster. Okay? If I go again slower, and I update the solution, again, you will see that now is 10 degrees instead of 13, because the torpedo is going slower. The bearing we are using to drive our torpedo changes, because we are forcing an interception course, right? Okay, so what happens here is that because of this very easy to understand lesson, the crossroads, we are making our own crossroads. We are launching our own automobile to hit the enemy. At the same way, you can see that here, range doesn't matter. It doesn't, because if we are at 12,000 yards and he's at 6,000 yards and we are moving at twice his speed, we are going to collide the same way we are going to collide here, by firing at exactly the same angle. In this case, would be zero. I mean, if instead of a car, this is a torpedo, and if instead of a car, this is a ship, if we are the sub here and we launch our torpedo at 10 knots, or 20 knots, and he's at 10 knots, he's going to intercept here. If we are at twice the distance and he's at twice the distance, again, the angle won't change, so that doesn't change. the torpedo will move, the enemy will move, they are going to collide exactly the same. It takes more time, but the collision is going to happen exactly the same. So what we are doing here is, instead of fixing our speed, what we are doing is forcing this course to be very close to zero. Again, go back here. This is 11 degrees. Ideally, we would be firing at zero of the bows. I never take care of this, but instead, if instead of 20 degrees, I would be using 10 as a reference point, then angle of bow would be 8. And then we would be firing at almost a straight line, right? We are recreating the collision here. And in a perpendicular collision, range doesn't matter, because it cancels itself out in the equations that rule the laws of movements that tell when the collision will happen. Okay? So that's why when I'm in a decocaine attack, I always say range doesn't matter, because it doesn't. It doesn't, it does a little bit, because there's always some kind of error, very minor, because you can see this is not a pure 0 degree attack, this is actually a 3 degree attack. In the standard attacks I use, which are at 20 degrees and 70 AOBs, there's going to be a little bit more error, because this is 12 degrees, this is not zero. I mean, we are not exactly in this collision course scenario. But the change is so minimum, the angle bow change is so minimum, that the error is very, very small. Maybe couple meters in front or behind of the enemy. And I usually attack at very close ranges too. I mean, if I were to attack at very low range, I would probably take a lot of care to fire directly ahead. But when we are very close to the enemy, it really doesn't matter, because the error doesn't mount up. The error mounts up with time. So what we are doing is forcing ourselves to replicate this scenario of the perpendicular collision course with our torpedoes. We are telling the torpedo that, okay, our torpedoes fire at 46 knots. We are here, the enemy is here, we are in the perpendicular course. Where do we need to shoot our torpedoes? And you are going to see it as well. This is practical, okay? I can set manually the range here. Okay? So you can see, right now we have a 5,000 yard range dialed in here. If instead of 5,000 yards, I tell this guy the enemy is at 8,000, have you seen it? We don't have to change anything, because it's perpendicular, it's a perpendicular shot. If instead of 8,000 yards, it's at 2,000 yards, this changes, but this doesn't. Well, 1 degree, but remember, this is a slight error here, because I'm not firing directly ahead. If I was firing directly ahead, let's put it that way. Let's do it that way, just for demonstration purposes. Little bit less, little bit less, until 0 degrees. Two more degrees. There. Now it's a little bit more. 360. We would be firing directly ahead. Right now we have this deal for an enemy of 300 yards. If instead of 300 yards is 4,000 yards, what happens? Oh joy, has changed a little bit. 1 degree, which is nothing. If instead of 4,000 yards is 10,000 yards, oh joy, this didn't change. Why? In a perpendicular course, range doesn't matter. Why? Again, because yes, if you are here, your torpedo is here and needs to hit here, it's going to last longer to reach here. But if instead of being here, the enemy is here, it's also going to take longer to reach here. So they will both reach at the same moment, and the impact will happen anyway, the same way it happened here. So that's why range in a decocaine attack, again, we are not trying to detoxify anyone, This is after Richard O'Kane, captain of USS Stang. In a Decocaine attack, you don't care about distances because they are meaningless. Of course, this is only viable when you are fighting at maybe plus 20 or minus 20 degrees of your bow and in perpendicular scenarios only. If the enemy is in any other course which is not perpendicular to you, range matters and matters a lot. But in this particular scenario, it doesn't. I have seen it. I mean, the torpedo data computer doesn't lie. We have said it's the same AOV, it's the same speed, it's the same bearing. All that changed was the distance. And the torpedo data computer was telling, well, I don't care. The torpedo needs to go exactly in the same direction. So, hope you have a little more insight on why this works the way it does. Again, I could go on and put a screen full of trigonometry and mathematical calculations or whatever that prove that this is the case. But just using a little bit of common sense with the crossroads scenario and by watching how the torpedo data computer works and calculates the stuff, you will see that these perpendicular setup attacks just give you the freedom of shooting at something without knowing the range. As long as you know the speed and as long as you know the course. Because if you know the course, the speed, and you set yourself in perpendicular attack, you will know the angle on bow, and all you need is the bearing, which you can find with the periscope or the hydrophones as well, and you will get hits. So hope that helped. Don't worry, there's going to be a chapter of the Let's Play today. This is an extra I chose to put up because of so many people who ask me why range doesn't matter. Because it seems counterintuitive. You say, okay, range should matter, right? Because the guy is farther away, the torpedo will take longer to reach there. But the problem is that the enemy also will take longer to reach there. And we are in a point of equilibrium where the enemy, the extra time the enemy takes to reach there is exactly the same time the torpedo takes to reach there as well. So the impact will happen anyway. Hope you enjoyed, guys. Hope you learned something. As always, thank you very much for watching and see you later.